This is the DBS Almater from Castle, and this video is just to show some of the screens that are available and what extent of data you can capture using a DBS Almater. So initially this first screen will show you the two measurements, measurement one and measurement two. As you can see, the bottom number is measurement one, and that's in setting to A weighting at the moment, so it gives you the A weighted sound pressure level. And the number at the top is measurement two, and that's showing at the moment the C-weighted sound pressure level. So we can have a quick look at different measurements that this meter will take. By pressing the right arrow key, we can see the LEQ, the CEQ, the peak, the min, the max, and so on. And we can scroll around those until we get back to the sound pressure level. Those other results are not showing anything at the moment because we're not recording. So just to show what that's like whilst you're making a recording, we'll press the record button, which is just the OK key in the middle. It's asking whether we want to add a voice memo at the beginning. You can turn that prompt off if you wish, or just skip it for now. And that's now recording the data that we've set it up to record. So I'm just going to show you down these screens what's available on the instrument. Although in the menu setups, when you set up for a measurement, you can turn any of these off. So for some applications, what's required is only a couple of measurement numbers or a couple of parameters. So in that case, you'd want to turn some of these screens off or some of these measurements off. So first of all, just to switch to the measurement one, to have a look at the measurements in there. We have the sound pressure level now, the LEQ, peak, min, max, sound exposure level, the 1 second LEQ level, and then a couple of other slightly more bizarre measurements, and back to sound pressure level. Pressing the downward arrow key takes you to different measurement screens. So there's a screen showing all the measurements together in one table. We then have a screen showing exposure calculations. So this is calculated exposure results based on the LEQ. And then we have measurements from the parameters from measurement one and measurement two for the percentile values. So this is showing a number of percentile values for measurement one and measurement two all on the screen together. And then this is set at the moment to measure single octave bands. This meter is capable also of breaking that down into third octave bands. So if we just stop this measurement, press the same button again. I have the option to not save it or to add a voice memo. I'm just going to save that away, and that's now brought the results back up on screen. So once we have the results, then the review of those results is performed in exactly the same way. Pressing the downward arrow key takes us to the screens. So there's measurement one and measurement two parameters overall. Here are the exposure measurements. And they're set to looking at an 8 hour exposure time. Moment, you can change that time on here as well. So the next screen is the percentile values for measurement one and measurement two. And then finally, we have the octave band results. With the octave band results, by scrolling left and right, you can see in the top left hand corner showing the different parameters. So the first one, LEQ, then LA, which is the 1 second exposure value, and the peak, the min, the max, back to the final fast setting result. And if we keep going, we can see these are all the percentiles, back to the LEQ. You can also, by pressing the switch key, switch over to looking at what the numbers are in each of those octave bands. So for the LEQ octave bands, by moving left and right, we can see the number that was available for each of those octave bands. Now, octave bands are only taken in measurement one. So if you want a particular frequency weighting, you need to ensure that measurement one is set up with that frequency weighting. So pressing the down arrow key takes you right back round to the main home screen, and you're ready to start again. Thanks for watching.